Mr. McLaren, welcome to William B. Idadobi State Historic Park, right here on the banks of the Sacramento River. Now, during the 1800s, pioneers had to be very resourceful to provide for their families. One of the most basic needs was clothing. Many pioneers would make clothing from animal hides or furs, but many others would use a spinning wheel. There's Mrs. Pooley over there. Maybe she can introduce us to some of our local spinners. Mrs. Pooley!
Mr. McLaren.
Hello, Mrs. Pooley. It's so nice to see you. How are you today?
I'm very well, thank you. It's nice to see you at the Adobe.
Mrs. Pooley, what can you tell us about spinning?
Well, I know a few things. Spinning's been around for hundreds of years, and many of my womenfolk friends here have spinning wheels of their own that they use to make clothes for their family. Now, a lot of them brought their spinning wheels with them across the plains with herds of sheep. But some of them came from the East Coast. They were made on the East Coast, and then they had big steamers and sailing ships that brought them around the Horn to San Francisco, and then were shipped to places beyond, and then purchased by women and their families to make their clothing. But the person you should meet is Mrs. Higgs, because Mrs. Higgs is a wonderful spinner, and she knows much more than I. She's here today. Come, please, come inside.
I don't think it's going to work for us.
Sorry. Mrs. Higgs, may I introduce my friend, Mr. McLaren?
Please meet you, Mrs. Higgs.
Thank you. Pleasure's all mine.
And you know Mrs. Calkins.
Good morning, Mr. McLaren.
Good morning, Mrs. Calkins.
Mr. McLaren and I were just talking about spinning. I told him it is a wonder how you work the wheel. Do you have time to tell us about how it's done?
Well, surely we can do that. It's just like magic to me. I can make so much more yarn so quickly.
Can you tell us how you start?
Well, you don't start inside. We need wool, and that's outside.
Well, Mr. McLaren is a shepherd. He'll be able to school us in shearing the sheep.
I certainly can. If you'll excuse me, ladies, follow me outside.
First, we have to gather the sheep together. Shearing the sheep is a big endeavor. We hold a shearing day in spring where we will bring all the animals in the flock together. We use shears to cut the wool from the sheep.
Those shears look sharp. It must be hard to hold them still.
Well, the sheep get used to being sheared and are remarkably docile.
Maybe they're pleased to shed their winter coats before the summer heat comes.
That's right, Mrs. Pooley, and we are happy to receive their beautiful fiber. If a spinner was going to use the fleece right away, they would spin in the grease, where they use raw, unwashed wool. This is last year's wool, and we have soaked the wool in a trough for several weeks to remove the lanolin. Sometimes this steeping of the wool can get quite odoriferous.
After the wool is washed to get the foul smell out, it is laid on the grass to dry. There's a substance in the wool that acts like soap that washes the lanolin out, but it still has to be picked. So from here, it is gathered, put in a bag, and brought to the house for picking. This is where the small hands of children are put to work because they can do the picking the best. Here we have Lily to assist. Good morning, Lily. Here's some more raw wool for you to work.
Thank you, Mr. McLaren. You can set it there. We have much to prepare.
Look at those nimble fingers fly. What are you looking for?
I'm picking out any twigs and dirt or any other dirty pieces that we don't want spun in our yarn.
As you can see, this work may involve the whole family, and many hands make easy work.
After we're done picking, we can move it on to Miss Higgs to help us with the next step.
Well, good day to you, ladies.
Good day, Mr. McLaren.
Now that Lily has picked the wool, if you would be so kind, I shall charge the cards.
At this point, we're hooking the locks into the teeth of the cards so that we can get ready to turn them into a single creamy mass. You see that they still have definition. Watch as it changes. we're ready to roll it up just like a rug. I can do several up before I go get ready to actually sit to my wheel.
Now for the inside work. My, that is a wonderful machine. It's a beauty. Could you show us how it works or tell us how you start spinning?
Certainly. Well, you know, before they made this, we had to do everything spindle. Oh, tell you. So we would use the spindle to draft out a little bit of our fiber, and then it was actually the spindle that we would use to twist the fiber, to put the twist in the fiber.
Oh my. Is right.
That seems like that would take an awful long time.
It does. So not only putting the twist in, but we would use the spindle to then take up the twisted yarn. This machine, though, can do both at once. So let me show you. We're going to use our foot to turn a flywheel. We'll use the footman to turn the wheel. The wheel will run the drive band. The drive band goes to the flyer, and the flyer has a bobbin. We have a brake band that goes across the bobbin to hold it back a little bit, and this is what's going to allow us to put in twist as well as wind it on to the bobbin all at once. So this is putting the twist in the yarn, and I'm going to draft it out. And just let a little bit of that twist go into the yarn and keep going. Now I'm going to let enough twist build up to where this is nice and solid and let it wind on. And then we go again.
Oh, that's much faster than using
that. Oh. It saves a woman so much time.
And I see the energy from your foot that's going to the wheel, that's going to the, what did you call this part?
That is the pulley that's attached to the flyer.
The flyer.
Okay. Yes. And it's that flyer that's doing so much of the magic work.
Well, it is like magic. I wonder what it is about the fiber that allows it to grab hold of itself like that and allows us to do the spinning.
That's part of the magic. But we can tell you how.
Now let's take a modern minute to briefly talk about the field of fiber science and some special properties of wool. Fiber science is the study of the different properties of fiber, how they can be used to create things, and how the different properties interact. Fibers can be man-made or natural. Some examples of natural fibers are cotton, hemp, spider webs, and wool. Wool has many interesting qualities. It is able to be twisted into yarn because the outer layer of each strand has tiny scales. These scales hook onto each other and bind together when they're twisted. Wool is able to keep you cool in the heat and warm in the cold. This is possible because the shape of the fiber forms air pockets. These pockets create natural insulation that keeps you warm by holding the warm air next to you. In warmer climates, the air pockets absorb moisture from sweat, keeping the layers of fiber from being weighed down, creating a cool layer of air next to your body. Wool is mold resistant, fire resistant, and environmentally friendly. It's been used by human beings for thousands of years and no doubt for many years to come. Let's get back to Mrs. Pooley and Mrs. Higgs.
After you spin onto the bobbin, is it ready to use?
Well, you could, But the easiest way is to use the lazy Kate. The lazy Kate holds the bobbins while we are going to spin the yarn together in the opposite direction. The twists oppose themselves and create a stable yarn. I can show you how the twist works by making a simple friendship bracelet. If you could hand me a lock of wool. Now this is a lock just the way it was hanging on the sheep before they sheared it off. If we take and open the end a little bit, then what we can do is we can draft out the fiber a little bit at a time. We're going to take a small pinch to start and we're going to pull it away. And then we're going to add the twist. Now this hand we're holding like a baby bird. And as we twist, we can pull out more and more yarn. Because the twist is gathering up all those individual fibers and turning them into a one-ply yarn. Once we've drafted out enough distance, you can see that it would start to twist up on itself if we just left it by itself. So we're going to put even more twist in it. Help me.
Oh, I'd be delighted.
If you would point a finger at me.
I know, that's so rude.
But we're going to use that to hold the yarn and let it twist onto itself. When it does that, the twist from one direction opposes the twist from the other direction, and it creates a very stable yarn. It lays wonderfully and doesn't twist up on itself anymore. So then if we secure the ends, take off the extra, we have a friendship. Just like that.
Well, thank you.
So now that we have the two-ply yarn, is it ready to work with? Or? Well, yes, but we need to get it off of the spinning wheel. So to do that, we're going to take it off on a nitty-knotty. A nitty-knotty is just a piece of wood. But what we're going to do is we're going to take off the break band. And then we hold this with our hand right here. And then it's a simple matter of looping it around and around. And what this is doing is it's forming a skein. So now that it's all on the nitty-knotty, we can take it off and form our skein. Hold that for a moment. Now what we do is we just give it another twist. And then if you could hold your finger out one more time so we can make this go in half. I'm going to tuck the end in, and then we now have our skein of yarn. It can be stored now, or if we decide that we need to roll it up into a ball, why then I just ask you to extend your hands out with your thumbs up, and then I find the end, and I can start rolling it into a ball.
Well, Mrs. Higgs, we certainly appreciate all the time you've spent with us introducing us to magical fiber science and the technology of the beautiful spinning wheel. Would you care to stay for supper?
Oh, no, thank you. I need to get home to my homestead. Thank you very much, though. I would take you up on the offer later.
You're entirely welcome.
Well, perhaps we can meet again sometime.
That would be delightful. Maybe next time we can learn to make some things with the yarn.
wonderful. It would be great to see you again. For to see a friend in a distant country is like the delight of rain after a drought.
Thank you so much. We'll make sure to visit soon.
Thank you. Bye-bye. Goodbye, Mrs. Hayes.